Hello everyone, this is Major Green, also known as Nitpicking Nerd, and I just watched a few more episodes of Stargate Origins, and it's still as low quality as the first few episodes. Very low production values, very bad acting, very cheap sets, everything looks terrible, very cheap looking special effects, but you know what, I could forgive all of that if at least it had a good story. But it doesn't. In fact, the story seems to be recycled from the original movie. It's basically the same exact thing again. So this whole series is totally pointless, uninteresting, unoriginal. And also, it suffers from the same problems as the new Star Wars movies and the new Star Trek series. The main character is Mary Sue, even worse than the one in Star Wars, Rey, and even worse than Michael in Star Trek. Basically, she's not just the smartest person, she's also physically strongest. You can see her beating up Nazis with hand-to-hand combat.
She's great.
And you even see her fighting a Goa'uld woman who looks like a bodybuilder with yellow eyes and a deep voice, so she's supposedly a Goa'uld, and we always saw that the Goa'uld were always physically stronger than normal humans, like 10 times stronger. And yet you see a skinny Catherine beating up this huge Goa'uld woman like it's nothing. So this is ridiculous.
You had to be a hero.
You needed saving.
So she's a total Mary Sue. She's not only the most clever person, she's the bravest, she's fearless, she's the strongest, the most capable person ever, with no flaws of any kind. So she's an even bigger Mary Sue than Rey in Star Wars or Michael in Star Trek. And by the way, it has nothing to do with her being a woman. If it was a male character doing all of this in one character, I would also be complaining that this character is overpowered, which is never good in any story, which is why I don't like Superman as a hero, by the way. I much prefer when you have a whole team like the X-Men and everyone is good at specific thing, and when they work together, they accomplish things. If you put everything into just one person and he has it all, he has all possible powers in just one person, that makes him overpowered. So this problem existed in the superhero franchise, and Superman is the best example in my opinion. He's like too good at everything. So it has nothing to do with women versus males. And I think shows like Stargate and Star Trek and Star Wars were always best when you had a team of people doing things together. And everybody on the team was good at specific thing, and so they have to work together to accomplish something. None of them could have done it all by themselves. It would not be realistic, it would be overpowered. And for example, in Stargate SG-1, you had a team of four people, so you had the leader who makes the decisions, he's kind of the heroic one, and you had a lady scientist who is the smartest one on a scientific level, you had Daniel Jackson who is good with translating things, he's good with languages, he's good with connecting to people, communicating with people, understanding other cultures. He's also like the moral compass of the team, convincing them to do the right thing. And also you had Teal'c, who was the muscle. Whenever you had to fight someone, you had to fight the enemy, then Teal'c was your best choice. He was the muscle of the team, mostly. He did have some depth, he was a complex character as well, but most of the time he was like the muscle of the team. And so everyone on the team had a specific set of skills that he was good at, and working together they were a great team. And yet nowadays, for some reason, they put everything into one person, and he just has sidekicks who don't do anything. So Rey in Star Wars, Michael in Star Trek Discovery, she's good at everything, she's the best scientist, she's also the best warrior, and she's the bravest and the most moral. Everything is in one person, and the other ones are only minor characters, so that's a very big problem. And here in Stargate Origins, you have the same problem. So you have all the best possible traits in one person. So Catherine is the smartest person, she's the bravest person, she's the physically strongest person, she's the most moral person. She has it all. She has all the possible best traits of everything in one person. She can do it all herself, and the other guys just stand by and watch. So what's even the point of having a team? What was the point of her taking those two guys with her? She's able to figure out everything. She figures out how to activate the Stargate, which makes Daniel Jackson totally useless later in the future. Why did she even need him if she can figure it out by herself? And she's able to communicate with the Abydonian people by herself. She manages to learn their language and talk with them. So she's good at that also. So she's good at everything, basically. So she can do it all herself, and those two other guys with her, they're just there to be impressed by her all the time because they don't actually do anything useful.
Don't tell me what to do.
So this is just ridiculous. Who the hell is writing it? And this is going on everywhere right now. I mean, in all the shows, in all the franchises that I used to like, all the writing seems to turn to shit. So what the hell happened? And it has nothing to do with her being a woman. As I said, if it was a male character, that would be the same exact problem. That was the problem with Wesley Crusher on Star Trek TNG. That's one of the reasons everybody hated him, because he was too perfect. He was good at everything. He was like a saint. He was selfless. He had no flaws whatsoever. He only thought about helping others, and he was the most brilliant one. And he constantly saved the ship, and the normal crew is totally idiots. So that's the same problem. Wesley Crusher was, I think it's called Garris 2, the male version of Emir Sus. So Wesley Crusher was that in the Star Trek TNG. He was too perfect. Later on, they turned him to be annoying in the later seasons when he came back. But then he was just annoying. So anyway, this has nothing to do with her being a woman. I'm a huge fan of James Cameron movies. I loved Alien 2. I loved Terminator 2. And both of those films had very strong female characters, and yet they were still realistic. And they had flaws, they had fears, they had to overcome their fears and to become stronger, to survive. And so it felt much more realistic characters. They were not just good at everything for no reason. They had to work hard to be good. Sarah Connor had to train herself hard to become the badass that she became. Ripley had to overcome her PTSD, she had to overcome her fears. She was terrified to go back to face the alien, and she did it anyway. And later she did it to save her adopted daughter, Newt. So her motherly instinct kind of kicked in. And so it felt so much better. It felt natural. It felt not forced. It was realistic. It was nothing like today's Mary Sue characters, who are just good at everything for no reason and have no difficulty and have no flaws of any kind whatsoever. So it has nothing to do with males versus females. I think it's great for a female to be the lead, to be the main hero, but you should still have a team effort. If it's a show about a team, like SG-1 or Star Trek or even Star Wars, then it should be about a team doing stuff together, working together to accomplish something, not just one person. That makes it too much like a superhero. And even in superhero films, you have like sidekicks who help out. The hero is not perfect most of the time. If it's an interesting one, then it would always be like a team of people. So this was kind of an overview of the whole Mary Sue situation in all of these franchises, and we have the same problem in Stargate now, and the bad acting and the unrealistic sets make it all even worse. It makes it all seem so ridiculous that I can't take it seriously. Because, you know, maybe a very good actor would have been able to pull it off, maybe it would make it believable that she's just such an awesome person, then maybe it could work, but as it's shown here, it just looks ridiculous. Also, the show tries to be kind of a comedy, which is a good thing. I'm all for being a more comedic tone. I think that's why SG-1 was probably the best show from the Stargate franchise, because it was so fun-loving, it didn't take itself too seriously, and it poked fun at itself, and it also had a lot of references to other science fiction movies and shows. So that's why it was a very fun show. And so I'm all for having comedy, but here it's just ridiculous. And it's not funny either. Like, if you want to make a totally straight comedy, just a self-parody, I'd be okay with that. But it's not funny either, so what's the point of all of this? So anyway, that's my rant about this show. So I'll keep watching and we'll see how it goes. I'm curious how they will wrap it up. I guess it will have to be a cop-out. She will have to lose all her memories in order for the original movie to make sense in the show. And also, the show has a lot of kind of strange things. For example, the Goa'uld have a permanent yellow eyes now. Apparently, they have contacts on their eyes all the time, and it's constantly yellow. So I guess they did that just to save money on the special effects. But really, how expensive is it to make their eyes glow once in a while? So I don't get it. I mean, I even did that in a parody video that I made of Star Trek. I made a character into a Goa'uld, and I made his eyes glow.
I think I'll summon my science officer.
It won't like your science officer. It does like you.
I warn you, as a Goa'uld, I now possess the strength of many men.
And it took me like 2 minutes with Photoshop and After Effects, and that's it. So they're telling me that now, in 2018, they cannot do these special effects cheaply, and instead they have to put those contacts on their eyes. So it just feels so cheap and so lazy. It's just unbelievable. So anyway, that's my rant. I'll probably make a few more videos talking about specific things in this show and in Stargate as a whole. This might be a good opportunity for me to rewatch some of the older episodes and the original movie. So let me know what you think in the comments below, and I will see you all next time.